In London, one of football's most famous clubs was about to become notorious, as Paul Merson admitted multiple addictions to drugs, drink and gambling.
The trouble in London is it's so massive that you don't know where the players are going. And I really didn't know half of what was going on social-wise. And it's sad in a way because you think, Jesus, we won 6 trophies in 8 years. How many could we have won? How many more we could have won?
Paul, how would you describe the treatment?
Hard. The hardest 6 weeks I've ever done.
What did you have to do? What would a typical day be like then?
Obviously a very difficult situation for Paul. Perhaps for a moment you'd direct one or two questions to Graham or to George. Rob?
I mean, I got changed next to Paul training every day for 8 years. I mean, very rarely did he come in and I thought, oh, he's struggling here. I mean, he might have had a night that, a late night, and he was just tired, but rarely did I smell alcohol on him. So I was quite surprised when it all came out that he said he was an alcoholic, but his gambling was more evident. You know, we used to sit in the canteen after training and Merson would talk about rugby league, American football, everything, you know, spread betting a lot.
It wasn't going to be the best Christmas for Paul Merson or Arsenal. January, and the FA Cup began with a red...
done anything like that, because he always used to preach, you know, you're playing for Arsenal, remember who you are and what you represent. And I because he was so steeped in the Arsenal tradition, I thought, well, he would never have done anything to sully the name of the club.
To make matters worse, after 2 years at the club, Jensen chose his manager's darkest hour to finally score his first goal for Arsenal.
Ooh, nice pie.
Now then, lardy boy, I would say that Andy Cole was Newcastle